First day we're messing with this thing and we're gonna do some fun stuff. So a lot of things to do in general to this. Van made gear, Baja lights, van compass suspension, hidden winch mount, wheels, tires, all that kind of stuff. I'm kind of tired. It is Sunday and nobody else is here. I'm just trying to get a head start on it. So we're just gonna do some fog lights and some ditch lights and maybe some like van made gear stuff. This isn't gonna be a whole lot of how to, but I'm just gonna kind of keep you guys coming along and hang out with me while I work on a Sunday afternoon. The first thing we're gonna start with is the Baja lights, basically because they're like super easy to do. Just pop this lens out and just pop the shroud out and then really just swap it and plug it in. Baja comes with all the plug and play stuff and it's a DOT SAE approved light, which means you can run it on the street as your normal fog light. Really easy upgrade for a significant amount of light output benefit. So let's just do that. So it's really one single screw and the whole fog light assembly comes out and makes it super easy to do this. You just release it, pop it off. This one's done. Make sure you have the right side. Now, these little sides here are gonna slide into some pockets in the bumper and you'll notice it when you take the other one out. But it's a fairly easy situation. This is keyed. You just plug in the adapter here that comes with the Baja lights. Shove it back up in there. And then you're going to put those side pieces in. And then put the bolt back in. It's that easy. And then from there, you just slide this guy all back in and you're done. Life is good. Let's see the other side. There we go. Good to go. They fit just like stock and put out so much more light. Also, a nice benefit is that they actually match the headlights. So normally the fog lights are halogen, so it's that weird yellowish, but this gives you a better light output and it matches the headlights pretty much. All right, so the next thing that I'm working on is the LP4s. So these are gonna be the ditch lights that go at the base of the windshield. They're typically designed to illuminate ditches so that you can see deer and animals and what's in the brush and all that kind of stuff. We're doing the LP4s with the backlight and got the Baja brackets and all that jazz. So let's put them on. So now that we got the brackets on the hood, we're gonna go ahead and put the lights on the brackets themselves. It's a super easy install. It's literally just a couple nuts on the bottom and then we'll put the lights on. All right, so this side is done. Well, the light install is done. I'm gonna do the other side, and then I'm gonna work on maybe making a bracket for the power switch to mount in the engine bay to run these lights, the grill lights, the LP6s that will be on the hidden winch mount from Van Compass, as well as any, the air compressor is gonna be ran by it, as well as the underbody lights will be ran by that power switch. We'll also be running a second power switch for the roof. It'll be externally mounted on the roof because Garmin says that they are rated for that. So we're gonna give it a try and see what happens. It'll make it a lot easier just to run one power wire up to the roof and one ground wire up to the roof from the power system, and hopefully make life a little easier. We'll find out. All right, so I'm just gonna end that one here. I don't wanna make it too long, but we got the fog lights installed down there. We got the ditch lights currently installed. I just have to wire them up, but I'm gonna work on some other stuff and show you guys another video. Appreciate you guys hanging out with me as we mess with the new Sprekko. And yeah, let us help you live life without limits.